So back here with Sarah Bookalus, local democracy reporter. We're going to start off by talking about Sackville Road. I know there's some building works going on there, but also roadworks. It's a bit congested. I was up there the other day, top half of Sackville Road, pretty congested with the Sackville Trading Estate, or former Sackville Trading Estate building taking place, which I think is 1,000 units, housing units.
Yes, there has been quite a big problem resulting from concrete from the new Moda development in Sackville Road. Moda are trying to sort it out, but what has happened is somehow some concrete has ended up filling up the sewers there. That has caused problems with water in the area and, of course, the sewage system backing up. So Southern Water have had to carry out these emergency roadworks. So that's why a huge chunk of the top of Sackville Road is currently closed off, because they need to clear that concrete from the sewers. It's thought to have come from the weir washing system, because when these huge developments take place, there are agreements to make sure that the roads don't get covered in rubbish, dirt, concrete, etc. And the concrete dust is washed off the wheels, and so it isn't trailing along Sackville Road. But unfortunately, somehow it has ended up down the sewer. Now, Moda and their development team, they are really sorry this has happened. It's very unfortunate. There has been a rumour going around that someone dug into the sewer and filled it up with concrete, but I'm pretty sure that we'd see much more catastrophic level of roadworks carried out by Southern Water if that had happened, whereas, you know, a bit of a concrete berg. This is one of the reasons why people are advised not to put things like wipes down the toilets, because the things like concrete and kitchen fat, it clings to it all and it creates these huge blockages, and it really causes huge problems for Southern Water.
Yeah, what about, we've got the kind of building works going on there as well. I mean, it seems to be going quite smoothly. Moda, the developer, seems to be working with residents, but it's a massive project there, isn't it? So it is, I know we've spoken in the past, it's really, really big. And I know that I'm not sure if you're aware, but the Brighton Gas Works plan proposal's gone in as well for Brighton Gas Works. That's going to be a similar size project, I think.
Yes, I mean, that is a huge scheme. Now, the difference with the gas works is that requires a lot of decontamination, because even though there are companies based there, you've got the buses and everything, there will be stuff underground that needs digging out. That one's going to take a very long time. Whereas this development in Hove, it was just an industrial estate, so there isn't the contamination. So that's why it has really started coming up quite quickly. I can see that one of the lift shafts is already visible above the wall line there. So this all of the homes there are available to rent. So that's going to be quite an interesting addition. I can see the New England development, that's a Legal and General one from where I live, and the tower there is really starting to show up behind Vantage Point next to New England House. So that's again another rental development. So these are quite exciting things that are coming, and hopefully will have an impact to provide more housing for people. So yes, now the Gasworks development, that has got quite a lot of opposition from local people under the umbrella of aghast because of the contamination. So yeah, it'll be interesting to have a good look through the planning application there.